Okay, we are going to learn k-dimensional tree, which is again another optimized binary search tree. Now, what is a k-dimensional tree? So, it is also known as a KD tree. Okay, and it is used for organizing number of points in a space called k. Space with k dimensions. So that is what it says. So a KD tree is a binary search tree where data in each node is a k dimensional point. So you know what is 2D, two dimensional, three dimensional point. So you are actually representing a tree in a k dimensional space. Okay, the non-leaf node of K tree divides the space into two parts. So if it is not a leaf node, the point or the data that has to be inserted into the tree is going to divide the space into a left part and a right part. So that's what they say. It is divided into two parts called half spaces, left half space and right half space. And the points to the left space is going to be a point which is lesser than the x value, and point to the right space is going to be a point which is greater. Right, so that is the points to the left of the space is represented by left subtree of that node, and the points to the right of the space is represented by the right subtree. Okay, so now we'll see how the particular how the space is divided and how we construct the tree. Okay, so now to determine if a point is on the left or the right, we have to you have to check in based on certain criteria. So if the root node is aligned in plane A, then the left subtree will contain all points that is smaller than the root node. Of course, you know, a binary search tree, a node is inserted in such a way that everything that is smaller than the root node goes to the left and that is greater than the root node goes to the right. So based on the same criteria, we will determine if it is in the left part or in the right subtree based on its value, and we'll locate the its coordinates in that plane. Okay, so next. Now consider an example. We have to insert the given points. Now it's a 2D plane, you can see, because you have x and y value. So if it is a 3D plane, you will have x, y, z value. So it's a 2D plane, and as I told you, you are representing it in some k dimensional space. So here we are taking an example of a two dimensional space. So based on that, we'll see a demonstration. These points has to be inserted. So we have to insert. So the first point that we are inserting is 3, 6, as you can see. So it is taken as in the x plane. Okay, so next point is 17, 15. So when you're taking 17, 15, now you're considering it in the y plane. Now it's going as x, y, x, y. So we'll go in that format. So first is 3, 6. Now here, we are going to check the x values when you're taking 17, 15, because 3, 6 is in the x plane. So as you can see, 17 is greater than 3. So the x value here is 3. So 17 is greater than 3. So it is put as a right child. And now 17, 15 is considered to be in the y plane. Okay. Now next is 13, 15. So next we have to add the point 13, 15. So now this is in the y plane. So 15 will be compared with 15. It is the same. So anything that is greater than or equal to the y value is put on the right side. So 17, 15, you are going to compare 13, 15 with the y value. So y value is 15, 15, 15 is same. So that is put in the right side. Next 16, 12. So as you can see, 16 comma 12, sorry, 6 comma 12. Now we have to compare 6 with 3 because 3 comma 6 is in the x plane. So 6 with 3, 6 is greater than 3, so it goes to the right. Now if you have to compare the y value because it's in the y plane, so 12 is lesser than 15, so it will go to the as it will go as the left child of 17 comma 15. Okay, so that you can see that is what it says. So you have to, you know, compare based on the plane which is assigned. So first it was x, so you will compare the x values. Next it is y, you will compare the y values, and then based on the y value, since 15 is you know, greater than 12, it goes to left side. Then 9 comma 1, you are first comparing 9 with 3, then 1 with 15. 1 is lesser than 15, so it goes to the left side. 1 is again, then this is in the x part, so 9 is greater than 6, so it goes 9 comma 1 in the you know, it goes 9 comma 1 in the right side. Okay, then comes 2 comma 7. So as per 2 comma 7, you can see 2 comma 7, you have to compare with 3 comma 6, because, and so 2 comma 7 will be compared with 3, so 2 is lesser than 3, so it goes to the left side, so it is placed 2 comma 7 here. Now the last one is 10 comma 9. So 10 comma 9 is compared first with 3, then 10 is compared with 3, so 10 is greater, then it comes to y. 19 and 15 is compared, so 15 is you know, lesser, so it goes to the 19 goes to the right side. Then again 19 and 15 is compared, so 19 is greater than 15, sorry, 19 won't be compared, 10 will be compared with 13, 10 is lesser than 13, so it goes to the left side. So this is how the comparison is done. So first you compare in the x plane, you compare the x value, and in the y plane, you compare the y values. So in the above example, this is how the values are placed in the xy dimension. So this is how the k dimension tree is constructed. Okay, so I hope you all have understood. So similar way you will be doing for other kind of points. So it is normally the applications of a KD tree is to find which point is closer, to find the nearest neighbor, because you can see it is distributed in 2D space. Here in this example, you can find which is the nearest neighbor of a particular point under reference. Okay, so that is one of the examples of using KD searched. Okay, next is a splay tree. So splay tree is again a optimized binary search tree, where everything you want, any operation you want to do on a particular node, that particular node has to be placed at the root position of the tree. Okay, so if it is not at the root position, you have to do certain set of rotations to move that particular node under reference from the given location to the root position. So for example, if you want to do an insertion, you will first insert it using the binary search tree rules, and if it is not at the root position, then you have to do suitable rotations to move that node to the root position, and similar is the case of searching. Okay, so the concept behind here is the recent referred node or the searched node has to be placed at the root position, so in order to save time in searching. So that is the concept behind here. Now, there are different kinds of rotation, as I told you, to rearrange the node so that the root node under reference comes at the root position. So you can see here, the first type of rotation is Zing rotation. What is Zing rotation? Like if you want to insert a no, if you want to move, or you are referring the node 3 here. So you can see the 3 here. You can see the node 3 here. So if you want to move 3 to the root position, you have to move 3 to the root position. So how to move it? You have to do a Zing rotation, in which it is similar to the right rotation of the AVL tree. So right rotation means you are going to move each node to the right. So as you can see, 2 will be moved to the third position. 2 will be moved to the third position. 3 will be moved to the fifth position. So when 3 is moved to the fifth position, the entire 3 and 4 comes on top. So 3 is going to move to the fifth position and 5 comes down. So in that case, the child of 4 becomes the left child of 5, and the 5 and 6 remains the same. So that's how it is going to be done. So what is it? It is similar to the right rotation of AVL tree, moving the nodes to the right in order for the node 3 to come at the root position. Next is the Zag rotation. It is similar to the left rotation. So suppose I'm talking about the root 5. So as you can see, root 5, node 5 here. So you have to move node 5 to 3 position. So when you're moving node 5 to 3 position, 3 comes down. Okay, 3 comes down, 5 moves up. So as you can see, 5 moves up, and when since 3 comes down, this node 4 becomes the right node of the node 3. So you can see here, this is how a Zang rotation is being done. It is similar to the left rotation of AVL tree. Now the next is Zing Zing rotation. Zing Zing means it is moving 2 positions to the right from its current position. So suppose I am talking about the node 2. So the node 2 is here. You have to move 2 positions to the right. That means 2 will come here first once, and then 2 will come here. So it is moving 2 position. So when you move 2 to the 3 position, 3 is going to go to the root. Then again move to the position of 3, then 2 will become the root, and if 2 becomes the root, 3 becomes the right child of 2, and 5 will become the right child of 3, and 4 and 6 becomes the left and right child of 5. So that's how the rotation is done for Zing Zing. Now coming to Zang Zang. Zang Zang rotation is similar to 2 left movement. For example, if I want to consider the node 6, it will first move to the 5 position, then if from there it will be moved to the node 3. So means you're making the 6 as the root node. So when you move that, when 6 moves to the root node, 5 becomes the child node of 6, and 3 with 2 and 4 will move to as the left subtree under 5. So that's how Zang Zang rotation is done. Then coming to the Zing Zang rotation. So Zing Zang means 2 kinds of rotation is done. In Zing, right rotation, and in Zang, left rotation is done. So you can see, talk about 4 here. So it is Zing Zang. So first left rotation is done, that is 4 is moved to 5 position. So 5 go, 5 and 6 will go down. In that case, it will go down, and 4 will take the position of 5. After that, 4 is again rotated in the right direction. So 4 will come here, so 3 will come here, and 3 it will move moving down. So this way a Zang rotation is done. Now going to Zing Zhang Xing rotation. As you know, Zhang means the left rotation will be done first, and Xing means the right rotation is going to be done. So Zhang, the left rotation, and we are considering 4. So left rotation means 4 will be moved to the position 3. So when 4 is moved to position 3, 3 and 2 comes down, will move down. And as you can see here in this image, after doing that, then 3 has to be moved in the right rotation. So when for Zhang Xing rotation, Zhang means you have to rotate first left and then for right position. So 4 will be left rotated. As you can see, it will be rotated left. It will take the position of node 3, and 3 and 2 will be moved down. And after Zhang rotation, you have to move using a right rotation. So 4 will take the position of 5, and 5 and 6 will be moved down. So that is Zhang Xing rotation. Next, insertion. How to insert a node? If there is no node, or you can see if the tree is empty, the node that has to be inserted will become the root node. And if the tree is not empty, it has to follow the binary search tree concept. That is, if the node to be inserted, if it is greater than the root node, it will be placed in the right position. If it is lesser, it will be placed in the left position. And after doing the insertion process, you have to splay the new node. That is, you have to select the required rotation and move the new node to the root position. And deletion is exactly the same way. The node to be deleted has to be searched for using the binary search logic, and if it is available, it will be splayed to the root position, and after moving it to the root position, it will be deleted from the root position, and the remaining tree will be joined using the binary tree search tree logic. So you can see a representation of a splay tree. So when you are inserting 0, 0 will become the root node, and when you are inserting 2, 2 is going to become the right child of 0. So it will be moved to the root node using Xing rotation. Similarly, the other node 4, 6, 8 and 13 will be moved, inserted in the same way. You can see the demo over here. So you can see 8 is again moved to the root position. So all is following the Xing rotation, because it has to be moved to the left position. Now coming the inserting 11. 11 is lesser than 13, greater than 8. So it becomes the right child of 8. Then using the Xing Zhang rotation, that is right left rotation, it is moved to the root position. So this is how you insert a node. And for deleting a node, you have to first find whether the node is available, and then move it to the root node and delete it from the root position. So deletion of 6, 8,